animals of the forest taught Robin Hood a bunch of different lessons.
What did they teach him?
They taught him how to hide and where to sleep, and they helped him out.
All right.
Robin, our brother, kind and good, was calmly come unto Sherwood, and the friendly beasts around him stood. Robin, our brother, kind and good, I said the donkey, shaggy and brown, I safely bore him up hill and down, I safely bore him from Nottingham town. I said the donkey, shaggy and brown, I said the hind, all white and red, I taught him for to make his bed, I gave him my grass to pillow his head. I said the hind, all white and red, I said the hedgehog, prickly and brown, I poked Prince John when he sat down, so he could not ride out of Nottingham town. I said the hedgehog, prickly and brown, I said the squirrel, all small and grey, I taught him to hide himself away, when the sheriff's men come, he climbs up to stay. I said the squirrel, all small and grey, I said the peacock, green and blue, I taught him his lady love to woo, and marry and wed him under yonder yew. I said the peacock, green and blue, I said the lizard, scaly and green, I bought him an audience with the queen, she gladly pardoned him therein. I said the lizard, scaly and green, Robin, our brother, kind and good, was humbly come unto Sherwood, and the friendly beasts around him stood. Robin, our brother, kind and good.
Oh, that's lovely.
To sing now, haven't you?
Yes, we do. And why do we sing to each other in this way, Your Majesty?
We sing, as history tells you, and as we know, it's our way of continuing our history. The written language comes in your time, not so much in our time. So we sing, we tell stories to carry on what our history is, so you have it here today, such as the legend of Robin Hood. So we're here today to have a singing circle. Anyone can sing, anyone can join us. We're going to try to do a tune here or there. Forgive us, or forgive me, my memory is not what it used to be, but we will do our best to keep you entertained, to tell you stories of old that are of our lives and how we continue tradition.
That sounds right marvelous, it does.
Well, I try. I do have to speak on public occasions once in a while. Iris, I am going to hand the festivities to you for this circle, since you are the most, well, next to Mistress Birdie, the two of you are our most musically acquainted.
Well, I think we should begin with the tale of the servant man. Will you sing it with me?
I recall that one. I will sing it with you as best I can.
Wondrous well.
It's of a damsel, both fair and handsome. These words are true, as I have been told. On the banks of Shannon, in a lofty mansion, her father chambered great stores of gold. Her hair was black as a raven's feather, her form and features to describe who can. But still this folly belongs to nature, for she fell in love with a servant man.
As these two lovers were fondly talking, her father heard them and near him drew. As these two lovers were together walking, in anger home her father flew. To build a dungeon was his intention, to part true love he contrived a plan. In swore an oath on all his mansions, he'd part his dear one from a servant man.
Her dungeon it was of bricks and mortar, with a flight of stairs leading underground. The food he gave her was bread and water, no bed nor blanket for her was found. Three times a day he did soundly beat her, till to her father she crying fled, saying, if I've transgressed my oath, dear father, yet I'll live and die for my servant man.
Young Edwin found her habitation, it was secured by an iron. at his leisure, he toiled at pleasure to gain the freedom of Mary Ann. And when he had found out his treasure, she cried, "My faithful young servant man." When her father found that she was banished, then like a lion he thus did roar, saying, "From old Ireland you shall be banished, and with my sword I will spill your gore." "Agreed," said Edwin, "I freed your daughter, I freed your daughter, do all you can. But forgive your treasure, I die with pleasure, for the one at fault is your servant man." When a father found him so tender-hearted, then down he fell on the dungeon floor, saying such two lovers should ne'er be parted, since love has entered an iron door. So since they were to be parted never, to roll in riches as couples can, this fair young lady, she rules in pleasure, contented with her young servant man.
Well done, love. Prior estate. Well done, little one. Well done.
Why, thank you. Why, thank you. But I hear that you, Lady Claremont, are also a wonderful singer. Tell me, would you sing one for us, please? Would you sing the one about the Jolly Robber?
Oh, Jolly Robber. Oh, Lady Claremont, I have not played in quite some time. Would you permit me to accompany you as best I can? Thank you, my dear. Would you mind, my dear? Thank you. Right. Unfortunately, the Queen cannot sit and play because there's too much of the Queen for this to stay in her lap. All right.
Oh, my lady.
Oh, Prioress, stop being such a prude. All right. Shall we?
Thank you.
And now, Friar Tuck, now you have joined our noble circle. Would you care to sing us a tune?
Friar Tuck, I don't see him anywhere.
Oh, I'm sorry, Little John.
Oh, that's me. Hello.
I'm sorry, Little John.
Wishful, it's all right. I forgive you.
Wishful thinking.
Ouch.
Anyway, oh. would you entertain us with the one about the fox?
Oh, yes, of course. All right. Everyone ready? It fell on the next night. The fox slipped out with all his might. Without coal or candlelight, he came into the town, oh, town, oh, town, oh. Without coal or candlelight, came into the town, oh. When he came unto the yard, so saw the geese they knew were scarred. Came a man quick as they fly, and false fox let it down, oh. Down, oh, down, oh. Out came the man quick as they fly, and false fox let it down, oh. Nay, said, will not I flee, with the goose shall I go far from thee. The goose and I, under a tree, among the berries brown, oh. Brown, oh, brown, oh. The goose and I, under a tree, among the berries brown, oh. Have a wife, and she lies sick. Many small whelps had she devil quick. Many bones they must pick while they are lying down, oh. Down, oh, down, oh. Many a bones they must pick while they are lying down, oh. Fox and his wife, without any strife, cut up the goose with a fork and a knife. They never had such a supper in their life, and the little ones chewed on the bones, oh. Bones, oh, bones, oh. They never had such a supper in their life, and the little ones chewed on the bones, oh.
Well done.
Thank you.
Well done. I'm not sure how appropriate that was for our circle, but a well-sung song, sir.
Thank you.
Raris, you don't know me very well. That was quite appropriate for us.
Thank you, Your Majesty.
My goodness, my lady. Would anyone care for some water, my friend?
I'm fine, my dear. Thank you.
Well, now I think that we should bring it back to the more appropriate songs for us, and we should sing the tale of Geordie. This is a tale of chivalry and the strength of a woman who brought her love home.
There was a battle in the north, and nobles there were many, and they have killed Sir Charlie Hay and laid the blame on Geordie.
Oh, he has written a long letter, sent it to his lady.
You must come up to Embertown to see what news of Geordie.
When first she looked the letter on, she was both red and rosy. She had not read a word but one when she grew pale as a lady.
Hello, what are you doing?
Go fetch to me, my good gray steed. My men shall all go with me.
Yes, over here.
For I shall neither eat nor drink till Embertown shall see.
They fetched to her good gray steed. Her men, they all went with her, and she did neither eat nor drink till Edinburgh Town did see her. And first appeared the fatal block, and then the axe to hurt him, and Geordie coming down the stairs with bands of iron upon him. Though he was chained in fetters strong of iron and steel, the finer man is Geordie. And she's down on her bended knee, and sure she's pale and weary.
Oh, pardon, pardon, noble kings, but give me back my dearie.
Go tell the heading man, make haste.
Our king replied more lordly,
oh, noble king, take all that's mine, but give me back my Geordie.
The Gordons came and the Gordons ran, and they were stark and steady. And I, the word among them all, was Gordons, keep your ready.
An aged lord at the king's right hand says,
noble kings, but hear me. Let her count out 5,000 pounds and give her back her dearie.
Some gave her marks, some gave her crowns, some gave her dollars.
Says, dear
she laid her hand on me, and this she did say. Stepped away from me, and she moved through the fair. And fondly I watched her move here and move there. Then she made her way homeward with a one star away. But the one had a sorrow that never was said. Then she made her way past with her goods and her gear, and that was the last I saw of my dear. Last night she came to me, my dead love came in. And so softly she came, that her feet made no din. Then she laid her hand on me, and this she did say: it will not be long, love, till our wedding day.
You may have noticed lots of people die in them, but they're all still fairly happy themes.
My favorite kind of songs.
Yes,
dying?
Dying with a happy theme.
Oh, the way a good life should be lived.
Yes, cool.
There once was a miller and he lived all alone. He had three sons all fully grown. When he went for to make his will, all he had left was a little old and the sun comes down to mark a brand new day. So he called to him his eldest son, son, oh son, my race is run. Fine miller of you make, pray tell me what toll will you take. Oh, father, father, my name is Bill, out of each sark I'll take a jill. You fool, the old man cried, out of such a little you could never make a ride. The sun comes up and the sun comes down, mark a brand new day. So he called to him his second son, son, oh son, my race is run. If I am the lord of you make, pray tell me what toll you take. Oh, father, father, my name is Ralph, out of each sack I'll take a half. You fool, the old man cried, out of such a little you could never make a ride. The sun comes up and the sun comes down, mark a brand new day. So he called to him his youngest son, son, oh son, my race is run.
Speaking of marvelous, do you think you can come up with an appropriate song?
Oh, I don't think I know any of those.
What about one of your lovely songs about your life as a traveler?
Oh, I know the perfect one. All right. This is called Freeborn Man of the Traveling People. I'm a freeborn man of the traveling people. Got no fixed abode, with nomads I am numbered. Country lanes and byways were always my ways. Never fancied being lumbered. Oh, we knew the woods and the resting places. Small birds sang when winter time was over. Then we'd pack our load and be on the road. Those were good old times for a rover. There was open ground where a man could linger. Stay a week or two, for time was not our master. Then away you'd jog with your horse and dog. Nice and easy, no need to go faster. Now and then we'd meet up with other travelers. Hear the news or else swap family information. At the country fairs, we'd be meeting there all the people of the traveling nation. All you freeborn men of the traveling people. Every tinker, rolling stone, and gypsy rover. Winds of change are blowing, old ways are going. Your traveling days will soon be over.
That was beautiful.
Thank you, absolutely beautiful.
So well sung.
Thank you.
But I do know a song that can match it for beauty.
Oh, well, please, I'd love to hear it.
My fair ladies, will you sing us Briar and the Rose?
Oh, yes, please.
I will, but I would ask, could we keep it a little on the briefer side? Could we do the first three and then we end it?
Lovely.
Will you join us in the end, Briar?
I will join you, I think.
I fell asleep down by a stream, and there I heard the strangest dream. And down by Brandon's glen there goes a briar and a rose. There's a tree in the forest, and I don't know where. I built a nest out of your hair, and climbing up into the air, a briar and a rose. Well, I don't know how long it's been, but I was born in Brenhans Glen, and near the end of spring there rose a briar and a rose. I picked the rose one early morn. I pricked my finger on a thorn. It grown so close, it's winding woe. An arrow through my heart, and all dressed up in spring's new clothes, a briar and a rose. And when I'm buried and in my grave, tell me so I may know your tears to make love grow, a briar and a rose. And when I'm buried,
loved that one.
It's great. And I do believe we have time for one more.
All right.
And what do you have in mind?
I have
She's a taskmaster, isn't she?
Beg your pardon?
I said, you're a taskmaster, dear.
I'm not in charge of a convent for no reason. These are for the slightly naughty kids. These are for the really naughty.
Oh, nice.
I thought we would say fairly well Northumberland.
All right.
The most challenging for the end.
Leave them wanting more.
All right. Shall I start it?
I would love it if you would, Your Majesty.
We prefer that you do.
Yes. Oh, thank you.
Come take me down when I awaken. I hate to leave my river town for some dark town that's God forsaken.
Tell what's in her hand. I do not know what fate awaits me. Fare thee well, Northumberland.
My heart beats for my streets and alleys, bumps and dwell in the borderland, the lordly shore and the river.